single interception because, oh, that's right, there were no defenders out there. A little bit different when there's live guys out there chasing the football.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've got to be thrilled to have this game still at nothing-nothing after the interception thrown on the very first play of the game.
They certainly do, and what I enjoyed was watching him on the sidelines because as the defense came off, he was there to congratulate him and really say thanks because he threw the interception. It didn't turn into any points.
And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Looking long for Thomas. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Here's Allen to throw it. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Another try after the first down sack. Allen is going to fire one deep over the middle. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown! Jalen Waddle, 57 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. And there, Charles, he lined up out left, ran the post, caught it over the middle, and the rest, as they say, is history.
And you have to love the scheme that they just showed there, because if you're going to run a deep post, you ordinarily have to get a safety out of the middle of the field. And you do it one of two ways, either by running routes at him that carries him away from it, or you either freeze him in the middle with routes that run underneath so that he doesn't get depth. Then you throw it over the top, and boy, what a successful play that was.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question. They've got his man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. They go play action. Now Mahomes. They'll roll him out right. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. It's a big play there for the Chiefs.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure's good, forcing the quarterback.
Oh, he tries to get it to Metcalf, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Reggie Nelson. Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. The two teams emerging from their respective tunnels a minute ago to the approval of this Baltimore crowd. They're all set as their Ravens will match up with the Buffalo Bills. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Throwing now is Allen. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. So there is the big arm of Josh Allen on display. He can throw it as deep as anybody, and that was an absolute laser.
And we knew that this offense was going to try and put pressure on the secondary. That was something they talked about with us. They knew that they had an advantage, pressed it, and there you go. Big play for a touchdown on their very first possession.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. No run back here for Duvernay. Touchback out to the 25. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Jackson slings it to Andrews, and it's complete. The tight end has it. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. Throwing again on second down. Jackson looking left side for Watkins, and he's got it. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To throw is Jackson. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 47. Jackson. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Their confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sidelines thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
That is definitely what we call on defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson. When you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. From the gun, it's Jackson, dancing to his left. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And the Ravens are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Jackson. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Justin Tucker for the extra point. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. And that is one, no doubt, that may come back to haunt them because the PAT tied it. They didn't need to go for 2.
I keep searching for an explanation. I know it's quick right here. I think I can search for the next year and not come up with anything that absolutely works. Kick the point, man. Kick the point. I don't get it.
And able to take it past the 25 and up.